More than 160 political leaders, policymakers, and development practitioners gathered in Marrakech, Morocco to come to a shared understanding of policy choices and investment decisions in capacity development that have underpinned significant transformation and enabled countries to achieve development goals.
Mr. Mohamed Ouzine represented the host government of Morocco and opened the event by emphasizing the importance of strengthening human and institutional capacities for sustainable development. The French government, which supported the global event, was represented by Ms. Beatrice Ravanel, who argued for capacity development to enhance its participation in defining, implementing, and monitoring public policies.
It seems to me that if we are looking for capacity, what we are basically ultimately looking for is capacity of human beings, what they're capable of doing, what they are, what they have the freedom to do.
At the end of the day, it really is people's capabilities that both pushes and inspires true change, lasting change. And this has a lot to do with an engaged citizen. And therefore, it is as important to invest, when we talk about capacity development, in the demand side as it is to strengthen those institutions of the state.
I think we have to build on both sides the capacity of how to move on all sides of that triangle, how to work and bring, have another kind of relationship where we can work together for solutions.
Whether we were talking about climate change, the MDGs, crisis response, global public goods, continuously the strong reliance or the need for a visionary leadership that then engages a very broad group of stakeholders around that.
Bien entendu, il y a une interaction entre le leadership.
Under President Vasquez's leadership, Uruguay invested $100 million in social protection programs and each child received a laptop.
Sumas y restos y multiplicación. Escribo los deberes en la computadora y escribo poemas.
Bueno, y para nosotros también es una revolución en casa.
Sierra Leone lost about 30-40% of all our professionals, talking about engineers, medical doctors. So we could not develop the country without addressing capacity. And because this was very close to the president's heart, he created the Office of Diaspora Affairs to attract Sierra Leoneans to return home.
Dr. Bingu Mkerika was re-elected in May 2009, and one major issue that he looked at with the government was to take education and put it as a priority.
Education is the greatest capital that we have for change.
Through a program called Worth, which combines literacy, banking, and business skills, Colette and thousands of women like her are redirecting their extremely limited resources to create new abundance in their lives and a sense of empowerment.
It came out clearly the issue of investing in people rather than investing in war. I think wars are sometimes imposed on us, and if they are there, we see how to go through very quickly, but give a lot of time in investing in people.
Parce que la jeunesse utilise son énergie qu'elle a utilisée pour détruire le pays, mais pour la reconstruction de notre pays.
Dr. Zaghloul's description of Earth University and its focus on an ethics-based curriculum that seeks to produce agents of change also resonated strongly with participants.
There is power in finding common solutions and promoting an open flow of knowledge and ideas between countries. And a key idea that repeatedly surfaced during the discussion was institutional twinning. As Joan Cravinho described, twinning for development is a new paradigm of strengthening institutions. By establishing a flexible mechanism of direct support between southern institutions, twinning arrangements can effectively provide long-term support.
A significant achievement of the CAP project, and also mine, has been towards building the trust and confidence of the Afghan government counterparts in the intent and abilities of the CAP coaches with regard to solving their day-to-day problem.
Well, I'm sad not to be in Marrakech. Unfortunately, my teaching commitments at Harvard do not permit me to travel at this time. But I look forward to hearing what happens.
I'd like to acknowledge how useful this conference here has been in looking at issues of capacity building and linking those to the Millennium Development Goals.
UNDP is really a leader in capacity development. So for me, this event is quite important because it gives an opportunity to shape the discourse and the agenda and the definition of capacity development.
I think it's an enormously exciting and important event. I prefer to call it a celebration because we are celebrating achievements and successes as well as learning from failures. That's also something we should celebrate.
This then was a marketplace of ideas and connecting champions and change makers. Here, UNDP has a key leadership role. So let's rise to the challenge.